Belinda presents this unabridged recording of The Billie B Brown Collection 3, written by Sally Rippin and read by Eloise Mignon. Billie B Brown, The Little Lie. Chapter 1. Billie B Brown has two colourful slings, three pink band-aids, and a bandage around her head. Do you know what the B in Billie B Brown stands for? Broken. Billie B Brown has been hunting dinosaurs with her best friend Jack. A dinosaur trampled all over Billie. It is a terrible emergency. Now Billie has two broken arms and maybe a broken head too. No, not really. Billie and Jack are just playing hunters. Now, Hunter Jack is pretending to bandage up Billie's broken bones. Jack and Billie live next door to each other. They play lots of made-up games together. I feel much better now, says Billie. She takes off all the bandages. Let's go back out and catch another dinosaur. Jack and Billie run outside into the garden. Billie has a toy bow and arrow. She shoots the arrow up into the air. Up, up, up it goes. Then down, 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 right onto the roof of the shed. Oh no, says Billie. That was our last arrow. Don't worry, says Jack. We can play something else. But Billie doesn't want to play anything else. She wants to keep playing hunters. Billie climbs the fence to see if she can find the arrow. The fence is very high. Billie climbs up and up until she is as high as the shed roof. I can see the arrow, Billie calls down to Jack. It's just on the edge of the roof. I'm sure I can reach it. Be careful, Billie, calls Jack. He looks worried. Maybe we should get your mum or dad. Billie leans forward, slowly, slowly, then, oh no, Billie tumbles right off the fence. Crash! She lands on her arm and shouts in pain. Jack runs over. Are you all right, Billie? Billie holds her arm tight against her tummy and rocks back and forth. She scrunches up her eyes. Ow! 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 She yells. Billie's mum runs into the garden. She bends down beside Billie. Oh dear, she says. What happened? I fell off the fence, wails Billie. Mum frowns. What were you doing? Never mind. We'd better get you to the hospital. The hospital? Even though her arm hurts, Billie can't help feeling a teensy bit excited. It's a real emergency. Chapter 2. Billie's mum leaves baby Noah with Jack's mum and drives Billie straight to the hospital. A doctor takes Billie into a special room for an x-ray. Well, says the doctor, I'm afraid your arm is broken, Billie. We'll have to put a plaster cast on it until it heals. A real plaster cast and a real sling. Billie can't wait to show everyone at school. Billie remembers when Lola came to school with a twisted ankle. She limped around all day and everyone wanted to sit next to her at lunchtime. Having a broken arm is very exciting. The next morning, Billy's dad walks Billy and Jack to school. When they get there, Poppy is at the gate.
"Oh," says Poppy, "what happened to your arm, Billy?"
"I broke it," says Billy.
"Wow," says Poppy, "how did you do that?"
"She fell off the fence," says Jack.
"Cool," says Poppy. "I'm going to tell Ella and Tracy."
She runs off. Billy and Jack walk into the playground. Soon, Tracy, Ella, and Poppy run up to her.
"Poppy says you fell off a fence and broke your arm," Ella says.
"That's right," says Billy. She feels very proud that all the girls want to see her arm. It makes her feel very special. Then Billy has an idea. She's just thought of something that will make everyone want to be her friend.
"Actually, I was rescuing my baby brother," Billy says loudly.
"What?" says Jack.
Billy jabs him in the ribs with her elbow. "He crawled up the fence and got stuck there," she says.
"It was really, really high."
"Wow," say Poppy, Ella, and Tracy. "That's amazing. Let's go and tell the others."
They run into the playground.
"Tell Lola,"
Billy calls out after them. Billy turns to smile at Jack. But Jack isn't smiling.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.